Doing BJJ does not make you fit. Before you leave an angry comment, hear me out. In this video, I explore the science behind cardiovascular fitness requirements for BJJ, and I analyze heart rate data from my subscribers and compare it to the science. A study published in 2018 in the International Journal of Performance Analysis in Sport showed that although BJJ training likely induces improvements in some aspects of aerobic endurance, it might have limited effect on others, such as VO2 max. And through this research, the author Karsten Øvretveit recommends alternative approaches to aerobic conditioning for BJJ athletes to improve their VO2 max. What is VO2 max and is it important for BJJ? Physical fitness is measured in many different ways. However, the gold standard for measuring overall cardiovascular fitness is the VO2 max. V equals volume, O equals oxygen, and max equals maximum. Therefore, VO2 max is the maximum amount of oxygen your body can utilize per minute, and it's expressed in milliliters of oxygen per kilogram of mass per minute. The higher your VO2 max, the better your cardiovascular fitness. Let's break down what the study actually found and how it applies to your BJJ performance. In this study, they took 12 BJJ athletes that had at least 1 year of consistent training and who maintained a training volume of at least 3 times per week. What they did is they measured their VO2 max and then they had them roll. Now during their rolls, they measured their heart rate and their lactic acid buildup between rounds. They rolled 5 6-minute rounds with a 90-second rest between the rounds. All the participants were between blue belt and brown belt and between the weights of lightweight to heavyweight. The VO2 max of the BJJ athletes is approximately 50 milliliters per kilogram per minute, which is similar to the age-matched general population and is slightly below that of wrestlers and judokas. During the rounds assessed, the athletes worked up a high heart rate during the first 2 rounds, and then they maintained that for the rest of the session more or less, with an average heart rate of approximately 85% of their maximum heart rate. And they accumulated a substantial amount of lactate buildup during the initial round of sparring with no meaningful reduction in the subsequent rounds that followed. They all rated their rate of perceived effort, or RPE, as hard, equivalent to 75% of their maximal exertion. Interestingly enough, the VO2 max of the athletes was negatively associated with the sparring heart rate of the athletes, which basically means the higher the athlete's VO2 max, the lower their subsequent heart rate was during the rolls that were assessed. What this indicates is that the VO2 max might have an important impact in the physiological performance in BJJ combat by delaying the fatigue process. Here's the kicker. The research showed that hard BJJ rolling is insufficient to significantly improve your cardio fitness through improvements in your VO2 max. You probably know through experience that when you take some time off jiu-jitsu and come back to the mat, you're absolutely gassed the first few rounds back to training, seemingly regardless of whether or not you maintain cardio during your time away. Why is this almost a universal truth? Well, it has been suggested in the literature that this is due to BJJ-specific endurance, which can be attributed to work economy and efficiency of your jiu-jitsu movements. That's because our sport is a skill-based sport. A more advanced BJJ athlete might be able to perform the jiu-jitsu techniques with a much lower energy cost and not rely so heavily on prolonged isometric muscle contractions during sparring. Aspects related to work economy can be likely modified substantially by sport-specific training. Important to note, however, is that the VO2 max and the work economy are separate determinants of aerobic endurance performance and should be trained separately. All that means is your VO2 max and your skill-based performance in jiu-jitsu are separate. Therefore, jiu-jitsu improves your jiu-jitsu economy, whereas your VO2 max needs to be trained elsewhere. Do BJJ athletes even need a high VO2 max? In short, yeah, it would definitely help out. Increasing your VO2 max will improve your intracellular oxygen availability during exercise. It will reduce your reliance on anaerobic processes which means you'll be able to increase your output for longer. Not only that, but when we look at the nature of BJJ competition, or even training for that matter, it's a series of 5 to 10 minute rounds followed by short intervals of recovery between rounds. The higher your VO2 max, the easier you'll be able to shift from anaerobic to aerobic energy systems, which will mean considerable performance advantages. Or in other words, the fitter you are, the faster you'll be able to recover between and even during matches. The whole premise of this research and what I'm arguing in this video is that due to the relationship between VO2 max and percentage of maximum heart rate, there is a proposed ceiling effect on that BJJ has on developing your VO2 max beyond that of the population average. And as you'll see in what I'm about to show you, when I analyze my subscribers' data, their heart rate data during their sessions, I observed a very similar pattern in this heart rate data. Your data, analyzing subscriber data. Okay, this is what you've all been waiting for. I wanted to compare what was found in the research with my subscriber data. So I reached out and asked people to submit me their heart rate data, and I actually got a really awesome, overwhelming response. So thank you everyone who submitted their data to me. I received over 130 submissions, and I've plot both the maximum heart rate in red and the average heart rate in blue on this line graph. For context, I've highlighted the different heart rate zones from 1 to 5. Most people have sessions that peak in the 80 to 100% of their theoretical maximal heart rate zone. It's important to note that these zones have not been age corrected, so the data needs to be interpreted with a grain of salt. It's interesting to see that most people at some point during their sessions entered the heart rate zone of 4 or higher, which means theoretically you should be seeing improvements in your VO2 max. But this trend is exactly what was observed in the research study we just covered as well. It also would obviously be really amazing if we had the VO2 max assessment of everyone that submitted their data, so we could compare it directly to the study findings. But what is interesting that despite the fact that these heart rate maximums would indicate that VO2 max should be positively benefited from sparring, in reality, heart rate data obtained during jiu-jitsu rolls should really be interpreted with caution, because it's more than likely that it's an overestimate of actual exercise intensity and energy expenditure. How to improve your VO2 max. So how can we use this research and this data that I've analyzed to our advantage? Well, improving your cardio for BJJ will improve your performance. Hopefully, I've convinced you of that. It will improve your recovery between rounds and even your recovery during sessions. It will enable you to spend longer in your aerobic zone before tapping into your anaerobic zone. And when you do tap into your anaerobic system, you're going to have more gas in the tank, so to speak, to increase your performance. So what we need to do is increase your VO2 max, and rolling just won't cut it. So there are two primary methods I'm going to give you to improve your VO2 max. The first method is known as HIIT training, or high intensity interval training. My recommended approach is doing something known as Tabata. You've probably heard of this before. It's essentially 20 seconds of all out 100% effort, followed by 10 seconds of rest for a total of 8 rounds for 4 minutes in duration. Do 2 full sets of Tabata for a total of 8 minutes. I prefer to do these sprints on the aerodyne bike, sprint treadmill, or stationary exercise bike. The second method I'm going to give you, when done correctly, is, to be honest, it's much more ruthless. And it's another form of interval training, but this time you're going to be doing 4 minutes of 90% of your maximum effort, followed by full 4 minute rest. So your work to rest ratio is 1:1. This will ensure that it's more or less full recovery, hopefully, between rounds. You're going to do at least 4 rounds of these for a total of 16 minutes of work time. I like doing these intervals on a treadmill or on a rowing machine. You know you're doing these correctly when you get down to the last minute and you're counting down the seconds. It should be quite difficult for you to get the full 4 minutes, but it should still be achievable. Let me know in the comments what you think about the cardio recommendations and all the data that we've covered. And if you want to learn more about performance for BJJ, then consider subscribing to my weekly BJJ performance newsletter. I only put my best content and updates, so there's no spamming, there's no bullshit. Link for that is in the description. Thanks for watching.